Okay, Epticus, I think we can get started. Good morning, everyone, in the chat and online with us. My name is Tom Monaco. I work with the IEEE Power Electronics Society, and thank you for joining us this morning for our continuing live webinar series. This morning, we have with us Epticus Kotrilius, and he will be delivering a presentation on optimal design of NPC and active NPC transformers, PV inverters. And so with that, Epticus, I will let you take it from here.
Thank you, Tom. I would like to thank everybody for joining this webinar. I will present our work on the design optimization of NPC and active NPC transformerless photovoltaic inverters, which has been performed with my student, Stefanos Aridakis, and Professor Fred Bladberg of the Department of Energy Technology of the Aalborg University in Denmark. This work has also been presented at the 2012 Third IEEE International Symposium on Power Electronics for Distributed Generation Systems, which was held this June in Aalborg, Denmark. Initially, I will perform an introduction on the design of transformerless photovoltaic inverters, then I will present the optimization methodology, then some optimal design results, and finally we'll draw some conclusions. The transformerless photovoltaic DC-based inverters are widely used in distributed generation photovoltaic systems, since compared to their counterparts with galvanic isolation, which means structures which contain a transformer in the inverter system, have the advantage of smaller size, lower weight, and higher efficiency, so they are frequently now used in distributed generation photovoltaic systems. There are various topologies of the power section in transformerless photovoltaic inverters. There are many topologies proposed, such as the H5 topology, the H6 topology, the Connelly NPC topology, and the neutral point clamped NPC PV inverter topology, as well as the active neutral point clamped PV inverter topology. These last two topologies are widely used in photovoltaic systems, since compared to the other transformerless photovoltaic inverter topologies, they have the advantages of low limited current and high efficiency. All PV inverter topologies, as well as the NPC and active NPC that our work is focused on, have the same structure, the same generic structure. The PV array is connected to the DC input of the inverter. The DC input voltage is processed by a power section, which is composed of power switches, freewheeling diodes, and clamped diodes, depending on the topology. And the power section produces a wave which follows the sinusoidal pulse width modulation principle. The high frequency harmonics of this SWM wave are filtered by the output filter, which typically is of the LCL type, as shown in this diagram, since it provides a more compact structure compared to the L filters or the LC filters. Then, a low harmonic distortion output current is injected into the electric grid. This generic structure is also applied in the case of the NPC PV inverter, with the difference compared to the NPC inverter is that the power section has a different structure. In all topologies, the power switches are controlled by a microelectronic control unit, which is either DSP or FPGA based. Now, there are more alternatives in the design of a photovoltaic inverter, except the topology. There are also alternatives in terms of the types of the power semiconductors which can be used to build the power section of the inverter. For example, the power section can be built using silicon technology using IGBTs, MOSFET, PN diodes, etc. Or alternatively, using the lately developed silicon carbide technology, using silicon carbide JFETs, MOSFETs, circuit diodes, etc. And also there are alternatives in terms of the output filter which can be used to build the output filter of the inverter. Either the L-type is a very common type of filter, or the LCL type filter, which as mentioned before, provides a more compact structure, reduces the volume of the inverter. Typically, the design process of photovoltaic inverters is performed using iterative parallel inverter techniques. But since many design variables are involved in the design process of the inverter, these iterative trial and error techniques are ineffective, as we'll be shown later. The target of the design techniques for the PV inverters, of the typical design techniques, are to maximize performance metrics such as the power conversion efficiency or the European efficiency. We have developed a new methodology, which is a systematic design tool, and is used to calculate the optimal values of the components comprising the inverter and the optimal types of the components, output filter, and topology. In contrast to the past proposed approaches, which have been used to design photovoltaic inverters, in this methodology, the PV inverter topology, the PV inverter component cost and operational characteristics, and the meteorological conditions which prevail at the installation site of the PV inverter are simultaneously taken into account during the design process of the inverter, since they affect the PV inverter manufacturing cost and the total energy production of the PV inverter. Now, we present you this optimization methodology. The design variables are the switching frequency of the power semiconductors employed in the power section of the inverter, the values of the components comprising the output filter. We consider an LCL type filter, so we have to calculate the values of the inductances L and LV, the capacitor CF, and the damping resistor RDR, and the types of the power semiconductors, output filter, and topology. In the proposed methodology, the design process of the PV inverter is formulated as an optimization problem. In this optimization problem, we target to minimize the objective function, which is the levelized cost of the generated electricity. The units of this metric of the LCOE are in euro or dollars per kilowatt hour. The levelized cost of the generated electricity is defined as the ratio of the PV inverter manufacturing cost divided by the total energy injected into the electric grid by the PV inverter during the year. The LCOE is minimized subject to various constraints, such as the output current ripple, the maximum switching frequency permitted for the power semiconductors, etc. Using the proposed methodology, we calculate the vector of the design variable, fix, which contains the values of the output filter component and the switching frequency, which minimize the levelized cost of the generated electricity of the PV inverter. The LCOE is a function of the vector X. And also, the manufacturing cost of the inverter, which is calculated as the sum of the component prices, plus the construction cost of the inverter in order to build the control unit, the heat sink, the printed circuit boards, etc., is also a function of the vector of the design variables, of X. And also the total energy which is injected to the electric grid by the PV inverter during the year is also a function of the vector of the design variables, X. So we try to find the vector it, which minimizes LCOE. The total energy which is injected in the electric grid by the PV inverter during the year is equal to the difference of the input power of the inverter, which is equal to the PV array energy production, minus the PV inverter circuit energy loss, the total energy loss of the PV inverter circuit. The PV inverter circuit energy loss is also a function of the vector of the design variable 6. How we calculate the total energy injected in the electric grid by the PV inverter during the year? This is we split the time period of 1 year in one hour time intervals. And the total energy is equal to the power injected in the electric grid at each of these 1 hour time intervals multiplied by the time step of 1 hour. The power injected in the electric grid at each hour T, at each 1 hour of the 8,760 different 1 hour time intervals, which comprise a 1 year time period, is equal to the difference of the output power of the PV array at maximum power point conditions minus the total power loss of the PV inverter. Now, how is the maximum power point output power of the PV array calculated? In order to calculate the first term of the difference, which gives us the total energy production of the energy injected into the electric grid by the inverter during the year, the first term is the maximum the output power of the PV array under maximum power point conditions. We assume that the inverter has a control unit which controls the span switches, such as the maximum possible power is produced by the PV array. This is a well-known maximum power point tracking process, which is a process performed by the control unit of the inverter. And all PV inverters have such a process performed by their control unit. So, since a maximum power point tracking process performed by the control unit of the inverter, the input power of the inverter, which is the output power of the PV array, is calculated using the operational characteristics of the PV array, open circuit voltage, short circuit current, how many PV modules are connected in series and parallel, etc., and the time series of the hourly values of solar radiation and ambient temperature which prevail at the installation site of the PV system during the year. So we input a time series of 8,760 different values of solar radiation and ambient temperature. And this, together with an appropriate model of the PV array, is used to calculate the term PPV, which is the output power of the PV array at each hour of operation of the PV system and the PV inverter during the year. The other factor that we have to calculate is the total power loss of the PV inverter. The total power loss of the PV inverter is equal to the sum of the individual power losses of the PV inverter components and subsystems. So, PTOT is equal to the sum of the conduction losses of the power semiconductors, either power switches or diodes, freewheeling and clamping diodes, plus the switching losses of the power semiconductors, the power loss on the damping resistor of the LCL filter, RDR, plus the core losses on the filter inductors, plus the winding losses on the filter inductors, plus the power consumption of the control unit, and this value is input by the PV inverter designer. It's typically of the order of a few watts. In order to calculate the conduction losses, the switching losses, the power loss on RDR, the core losses on the filter inductors, and the winding losses on the filter inductors, we use appropriate mathematical model of the PV inverter topology in each case, for, separate models for the MPC inverter and separate equations for the active MPC inverter. I will provide you some literature containing these equations at the end of the presentation. The flowchart of the optimization process. The designer of the inverter inputs the PV inverter specifications, the electrical parameters, the cost of the devices which are used to build the PV inverter, and these devices are the power semiconductors, the magnetics, and the capacitors, and the constraints, the grid code standards which must be taken into account during the design process of the PV inverter. And these grid codes and standards typically involve the maximum harmonic permitted harmonic distortion of the output current, which is injected to the electric grid. Also, as mentioned before, the PV array operational characteristics, open circuit voltage, short circuit current, etc., and the solar radiation and ambient temperature time series during the year. All these are input in the mathematical model of the PV inverter. Iteratively, new sets of the design variables of the vector X we saw before are produced. And for each of these sets, it is first checked if the constraints of the optimization problem are satisfied. These constraints are if the harmonic distortion of the output current is within the permitted limit, if the switching frequency of the semiconductor is lower than the maximum limit which is permitted according to the manufacturer's specification, and then the corresponding value of the objective function of the inverter is calculated, and this objective function is the LCOE, the levelized cost of the generated electricity. This process is iteratively produced. New values of design variables are produced, and the value of the objective function is iteratively calculated, and it is checked if the optimum solution has been derived. The process of producing new values of the design variables and checking if the optimum solution has been derived is performed using genetic algorithms, which are an optimization method, an optimization algorithm, which is capable to obtain the global optimum solution in non-linear optimization problems with relative computational efficiency. After the global optimum solution has been derived, then the corresponding optimal values of the design variables are output in order to build PV inverter. This process is iteratively performed for each type of power semiconductor, for each type of output filter, and for each type of PV inverter topology that the designer of the inverter wants to consider. For example, this process may be performed for alternative part numbers of power switches, of IGBT power switches that the inverter wants, the inverter designer was taken to consider in the optimization process. Or it may be performed for alternative types of the output filter. For example, it can be performed for an LCL type filter, as shown previously, or it can be performed for NL type filter, where in this case we set the values of LG and CF to zero. And so what remains from the LCL filter is NL type filter in this case. Or it can be performed for alternative inverter topologies. I will show you now results for an active MPC or an MPC inverter. So this process, although the vector of design variables, the vector X, contains only the values of the output filter and the switching frequency, the complete process is iteratively produced to considering alternative types of power semiconductors, output filter, EPV, inverter topology. By performing this process for each of these types, We then select the configuration with the lowest LCOE among all these configurations with alternative types or semiconductors, auto filter, or PV inverter topology. Now, some optimal sizing results. We applied this methodology for the design optimization of a 2 kilowatt 220 volt single phase NTC inverter and an active NTC PV inverter. The power semiconductors we consider are commercially available IGBTs and diodes. The method was implemented in MATLAB using the global optimization toolbox of MATLAB. The PV array connected at the input of either the MPC or the active MPC inverter consisted of PV modules connected in series, and each PV module had a nominal power rating of 175 watts and 35.4 volts under standard test conditions. Here are the optimization results for each of the MPC and active MPC inverters for various installation sites in Europe. So we have performed the design process, the design optimization process, in various installation sites in Europe. In Athens, Greece, Oslo, Norway, Freiburg, Germany, and Murcia, Spain. In each of these cases, we performed a different optimization process for each of the NPC and active NPC inverters. So a different set of optimal values of the design variables has been derived in each case. Since different solar radiation and ambient temperature conditions prevail at the installation site, a different set of optimal values has been calculated in each PV inverter case. And the different, of course, optimal LCOE value. Compared to the non-optimized inverters, a non-optimized inverter was an inverter designed using a typical design process. Compared to the non-optimized inverters, the optimized inverters were derived using the proposed methodology have lower LCOE by 6.7 up to 8.6%. Murcia, Spain is a location which is located in the southernmost site in Europe. And at this site, the highest solar radiation potential is available among the rest installation sites we consider. In this installation site, the minimum optimal LCOE has been derived for both PV inverter topologies compared to the rest of the installation sites. Here is the optimum LCOE, which has been derived in each installation site for each of the NPC and active NPC inverters. In each site, the LCOE deviation or the optimal values of the LCOE deviation for the NPC and active NPC inverters is less than 1%. Among all installation sites from the southernmost site in Europe, in Murcia, Spain, up to the northernmost site, which is Oslo in Norway, the LCOE deviation, the maximum LCOE deviation, is 68%. This is a plot of the cost of the optimized and non-optimized inverters. A non-optimized inverter has a fixed structure, so it has a fixed cost, either both the NPC and the active NPC. Non-optimized inverters have a fixed cost because they have a fixed structure. The optimized inverters have a different cost in each installation site because in each installation site, the optimized inverter has a different structure, different values of the switch frequency, and different values of the components comprising the output filter. And this is the reason that for each topology, In each installation site, there is a different cost. The optimized MPC and active MPC PV inverters have lower cost compared to the non-optimized inverter by 3.6 up to 3.75%. In this plot, there is the energy injected into the electric grid during the year, the total yearly energy, which is injected into the grid by the optimized NPC and active NPC inverters and the non-optimized NPC and active NPC inverters. In each case, since there is a different solar radiation and ambient temperature conditions in each installation site, each inverter, depending on its structure, injects a different amount of energy into the electric grid. The optimized NPC and active NPC PV inverters inject more energy into the electric grid compared to the non-optimized inverters by 3.1 up to 5.3%. In the upper diagram, there is the European efficiency of the optimized and non-optimized inverters. The optimized NPC and the NPC inverters have higher European efficiency by 10.1 up to 10.9%. In the lower diagram of this slide, there is a higher efficiency at the efficiency at maximum AC power of the optimized and non-optimized NPC and active NPC inverters. The optimized inverters have higher efficiency at maximum AC power by 3.32 up to 3.86% compared to the non-optimized PV inverter. All these results presented correspond to an example. They are results produced for the specific components we considered in this optimization process. They are just an example. Different results will be produced if we use different components. But also, although the results, the values, the absolute values will be different, the optimized inverters will have better performance compared to the non-optimized inverters in terms of all those performance metrics described before, such as LCOE, the cost, the total energy production, the efficiency, either the European or the efficiency at maximum power. According to the previous results, the optimized active MPC PV inverters compared to the optimized MPC inverters have higher LCOE, higher cost, and they eject equal or less energy into the electric grid. These are not good results, but they have higher efficiency at maximum AC power. And this is an example demonstrating that the efficiency at maximum AC power does not guarantee the design of the most cost-effective PV inverter. Thus, it is a performance metric, which, although is typically used, as mentioned in the introduction, during the typical design process of conventional PV inverters, it does not guarantee the design of the most cost-effective PV inverter. In these two plots, I plotted the conduction and switching losses at maximum AC power. In the upper diagram for the NPC inverter, and the lower diagram for the active NPC inverter. In the upper diagram, the conduction losses of the NPC inverter at maximum AC power are shown in red, and they are higher by 0.43 up to 0.45% compared to those of the non-optimized inverter. The switching losses shown in blue of the NPC inverter are higher by 275% compared to those of the non-optimized inverter, which is not a good performance in terms of the conduction and switching losses. Also, for the active NPC inverter shown in the lower diagram, the conduction losses are lower by 0.1% compared to those of the non-optimized inverter, and but the switching losses are higher by 263 up to 275%, which is also not a not good performance in terms of the switching losses. But although the optimized inverters have worse performance compared to the non-optimized inverter in terms of the conduction and or the switching losses, they have lower electricity. And this is also an example demonstrating that the use of the conduction or switching losses as a performance metric in order to design an inverter also does not guarantee the design of the most cost-effective EV inverter configuration. So some conclusions now. The proposed design methodology for the optimal design of MPC adaptive MPC PV inverters is capable to explore the impact of the PV inverter tax on the manufacturing cost and power loss trade-off, matches the optimized PV inverter structure in terms of values of components, type of components, filter and topology to the operating conditions of the PV array, and the optimized NPC and active NPC PV inverters, which are derived using this methodology, have lower levelized cost of electricity generated and manufacturing cost, and are capable to inject more energy into the electric grid. So they provide maximum economic benefit to the user of the PV system. This work has been presented at the paper Optimal Design of MPC Adaptive MPC Transformerless PV Inverters, which has been presented at the 2012 Third IEEE International Symposium Power Electronics for Distributed Generation Systems, which was performed this year. And the full paper is available at IEEExplore.IEEE.org. This is my contact information. My email is efkogt@electronics.tuc.gr. I will be really glad to contact me and discuss any of your comments or suggestions on this work. Thank you very much.
FK, thank you very, very much. I really appreciate taking the time out to deliver a presentation for PELS this morning. I did not see any questions come through in the chat. I did ask a few times. So I think we can conclude this morning's webinar. And once again, I want to thank everyone, all the participants, for taking the time to join us. And special thanks to Efthikis Katrilius for delivering a
fantastic presentation. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Efthikis. Have a great day.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Tom. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye, everyone.